So if we take a look down below this graph, we've already answered this first part. We're going to say at the equivalence point, the pH of a strong acid and strong base is equal to 7. Now, if we're looking at a strong acid and a weak base, just remember, whoever is weak will dictate what kind of solution you have at the end. Since we're dealing with a strong acid, the acid is stronger now than the base. So it's going to say, since I'm stronger, I'm going to want my solution at the end to be acidic. So anytime you're titrating a weak acid and strong base together, at the equivalence point, the pH is going to be less than 7. It's going to be acidic. And it's acidic because the acid is stronger. Whoever is stronger will tell us what kind of solution we have. In the first example, they both were strong. So we wind up with a draw, which means neutral. That's why the pH is equal to 7. Now for the last scenario, we have a weak acid and a strong base. Now the base is stronger, so it's going to dictate what kind of solution we have. Because we're dealing with a strong base, it's going to want to have a basic solution. So the solution has to have a pH greater than 7 at the equivalence point. So just remember these fundamentals. And as we start to do more acid and base titration questions, keep this in mind as we face every type of question we're going to see. So just remember, the equivalence point is when we have equal moles of acid and base. And depending on what we're titrating, whether they both are strong or one is strong or weak, the equivalence point could have a pH equal to 7, less than 7, or greater than 7.